Welcome back. Well, to shed more light on Women's Day, International Women's Day, we have the pleasure to have this phono with Mrs. Pakinam Ragab, member of one of the Egyptian NGOs. Good afternoon, Mrs. Ragab.
Hello, good afternoon.
Mrs. Ragab, March marks Women's Day in Egypt and the whole world. So how do you view the significance of this occasion?
Well, women have always been Egypt's trumping card. For so many years, women have played a key role in all sectors, on all levels. Actually, you can't even find an Egyptian revolution without a clear footprint for women in it. So we're starting with 1919 revolution, back then until 2013. So apart from their political contribution, women have always they were always able to adopt different and tough social situations, for example. So they've always deserved to be recognized and appreciated. One day is not really enough.
Yes. How do you assess the state's keenness in supporting women and their role in the society?
Well, I believe that focusing on education, which prepares women for the job market, is a crucial thing, and also taking action against the negative inequalities faced by women that would find, like, engaging women in leadership and decision-making on all levels and accessing all sectors, which includes the government and the parliament, like what is happening nowadays.
What are the institutional and society changes that is still needed to be made to boost women empowerment?
Well, in my opinion, there are two essential areas that we should target. First of all, is the education, of course, and second is the engagement of men and youth as partners for women's empowerment. And because there are still so many changes. There are still so many challenges. For example, the gender-based discrimination that that is inherited in our society, and there's also the negative gender stereotypes that steer women away from educational choices that would empower them to have a stronger role in society.
Yes, Mrs. Ragab, would you like to give us an idea about Anna Masriya institution, or I'm Egyptian, and what are the services that the institution provide?
Well, for a couple of years, we've been conducting so many services. For example, we've been funding small projects for women to encourage them to work even from home. Also, we've been conducting workshops and campaigns to raise their awareness, and we've been assisting families in need, even in remote areas like in Sinai. So we've been covering a lot of governorates in Egypt, like the base, of course, is in Alex, run by Mrs. Marwa Hafiz, our head of the association. Also, we've been covering Kafr Sheikh, Bahira, Cairo, and Sinai.
Yes. What are the upcoming events that the institution will participate in?
We plan to continue the our leading activities, like a lot of social visits and services. We've been searching to help the families in need, children suffering from cancer, elderly, home visits, school visits, and visits to orphanages. So it's a chain. We've been conducting this for a couple of years, and we're continuing also to work in all the fields.
Yes, Mrs. Ragab, today in a post on his official Facebook page, President Abd al-Fattah al-Sisi have sent a message of appreciation and respect for the Egyptian women and praised the role that is played by the Egyptian women, being the mother, being the sister, supporting the family, and being the pillar of any family. How do you evaluate or comment on the statements of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi on, in a message on his official Facebook page?
Well, I believe in that women now are in their golden era, because the President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi has honored a huge number of women who were described as, by him as social figures. For example, in the year 2017, it was decided by him to be named the Women's Year as recognition for what they did for their country. And until, and since then, actually, and I think he, that the President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi is empowering women in Egypt by giving them a lot of chances in the government and parliament. And now we are having very good examples of very active ministers and women, having a clear role in the society.
Yes. How do you see also the role that is played by President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi appreciating Egyptian women? And he, several years ago, he allocated a special year for women.
Yes, that's what I've just said. Like, but also, he's been very much concerned with reissuing the laws concerned with women's rights. Which really facilitated the emerging of NGOs aiming at providing a significant service to the society in general and women empowerment in particular. So it's really giving a chance to women in society with the help of other institutions and NGOs and the government and the parliament to enhance the women's role in society and to eliminate all the challenges that that women have been facing for so many years.
Yes, Mrs. Ragab, also President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, since the COVID-19 started, he was always calling on the Egyptian woman who is considered the pillar of the family, how to help her family and how to spread awareness and to advise the members of her family and take care, good care of them. What's your comment?
Well, I see actually on ground there are so many activities taken. Like, for example, according to Dr. Maya Morsi, the president of Egyptian National Council for Women, there has been a lot of dedication for so many a number of amounts for the national budget for supporting female breadwinners and the poor families. 34 million women benefited from the food ration cards. 10 million benefited from the health care support, and 8 million benefited from the families and reproductive health services, which I think for the time being it's really a lot in a very short time.
Yes, I thank you very much for your time, for your valuable information, Mrs. Pakinam Ragab, the member of an Egyptian NGO, and congratulations on Women's Day. Thank you very much for joining us. Well, ladies and gentlemen, a short break and I'm going to be back with you.